Friends, last night I heard about a case of innuendo in Arundhalpet Guntur police station. So you may not be knowing about the innuendo. I have discussed about the defamation, which is the law of tort. At the same time, innuendo is also one of the torts or one of the types of defamation. So a man's reputation is 100% valid, and it is more than his material wealth, because everybody wants to keep up his reputation. If the reputation is lost, it is more than the wealth, material wealth of his. So that's why everybody thinks high of his reputation, right? So if you directly comment on the reputation, if you want to defame a person, it's a direct attack on his reputation, right? So nobody wants his reputation to be damaged. And if at all you tell something, you utter something, that is what is called a slander, and you will file a case. And if you write something, and that means if you defame in a permanent way, like printing of pamphlets or other things, you can be taken to the task of libel. So we have discussed about libel and slander also. So libel means defamation in writing or in a printed media or permanent form, like movie, pictures, or pamphlets, all these things. Slander means only loose tongue or uttering by words, slander. Now, there is another type of defamation. This is what is called as innuendo, I-N-N-E-U-N-D-O. Now, normally we pronounce it as invendo, but it is innuendo, right? So, normally, if you see something, the material may not be defamatory by outline. But if you go to the latent or secondary meaning, then it will become defamatory. So in other words, we call it as sarcastic language. So you may be hearing so many sarcastic words. Anta Sri Vaishnavale Kani Bottalavana Garli Poinai. That means somebody has knocked away the so-called prawns. Or Bottalavana Royal Antar. Anyway, so ilaga. So these are sarcastic comments. So by nature, by first seeing, you cannot find that it is defamatory. But if you go and read in between the words, and if you try to understand the language, the latent or secondary meaning of the same, it amounts to defamation. Normally, the press people and so many others, they use such language only. Please remember, in defamation, it must be straightforward. I told you. Suppose if Arvind Kejriwal calls Nitin Gadkari as a chore, it's a direct attack on his reputation. It's that if somebody calls another person as a rogue, as a rascal, or as a cheater, all these things, they are direct, they are slander. But here what happens is, the defamation here is innuendo, is a typical type. By appearance, you do not know that it is a defamation. I will tell you a couple of examples, then you will easily understand. For example, A tells B that she is C, that C is under treatment with Dr. Q. Is there anything wrong? A is telling B that C is under treatment with Dr. Qureshi. Fine, no problem. If you get any bimar, if you get any this thing, any defect, definitely you will go to the doctor and you will get treatment. There's no problem. But here, the defamation, the innuendo will come. What happens is, Dr. Qureshi is supposed to be a psychiatrist. Now, you once again study the thing. She is under treatment with Dr. Qureshi, who is a psychiatrist. That means he is having a psychological problem. That means he is mentally deranged, or he is having a mental problem. That means his health is not good in the psychological way. So actually, C is very hale and healthy, but this is innuendo. Second example. Suppose A tells B that C, a woman, gave birth to a child. Is there anything wrong? A woman, normally, she gives birth to a child, definitely. Maybe a male child or female child. But the innuendo comes when the particular woman is not married. An unmarried woman giving birth to a child means definitely it is a castigation or attack on her character. That means she has given birth without marriage, means she has got some illegal contact. That means her character is bad. This is in Indo. Understand? So, straight away, it doesn't appear like any defamation. But when you go through the sentences or when you understand, when you have to understand the lines in between, so that means it is an indirect and also implied reference. That is what is innuendo. So now let us take a couple of case laws also. So very famous, normally you will be hearing about press only. Very famous case law is Rajagopal versus Mrs. Jayalalitha. It happened in the year maybe 2006. What happened is this Rajagopal is the editor of a newspaper called as Nakiran. Nakiran is a very popular newspaper in Tamil Nadu. So they have written in the newspaper that regarding the health condition of Jayalalitha. There is no Jayalalitha, madam, she has no tie-up with any political party. Yes, ADAMK, she is the general secretary of AIADMK and she doesn't have any ties up with any political parties. But she is having a tie-up with her confidant, her confederate. That means indirectly you can understand that she is the Shashikala. So every day she takes tablets of 4500 mg and she will be taking only through the hands of the so-called her confederate and other things also like that. So in an indirect manner they have sarcastically stated that about her health condition. What do you understand? Normally you may, by seeing it you will understand that Madam Jayalalitha is taking some treatment, that's all. But here when she is when you go into the details, so she doesn't have a tie-up with other political parties. That means she has got a tie-up with Shashikala. You can understand that relation. You can understand. And she doesn't take medicines from anybody except Shashikala. So, and other things. That means she takes money also. All these things, they have been indirectly, they have been mentioned. So, she filed a case of defamation against Nakiran paper. So, a lot of things. So, Constitution 19, freedom of expression, all these things were discussed. But the judge has categorically stated that the inner meaning should also be good. The inner meaning, it is clearly in this case, says that she is not healthy. And the attack on her character also, that's why it is held to be innuendo and compensation was awarded to the late Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha. The second is very famous case. It's a dispute between a lady advocate by Nalini and also another paper by name Malayal Manorama in Kerala. Malayal Manorama is a very popular newspaper in Tamil Nadu. Actually, you have to study the case law like this. Machu versus Nalini. Machu is the chief editor of the particular paper. First, Nalini filed a case of innuendo against him. Right. So, when you go into the details of the case, what happened is, this Nalini, she was instrumental in getting a murder case accused to get out on bail. Normally, every lawyer will be doing that. So, he's instrumental to get him out of on bail by producing fake sureties. So, this came to light when the original sureties by name Kalanathan and another person, I think his name, let me see it, by name Chandu and Neelakantan. Yes. The original sureties by name Chandu and Neelakantan, they came up to the court when that man absconded after 2 years, and they came to the court and they stated that they were not the persons who stood as a surety. That means some fake sureties in the name of Chetan and this Kalanathan has been implied or invoked by, put into by the so-called advocate Nalini, right? So while things were that, so this Nalini madam went to the house of the accused Balakrishnan, and actually she wanted to trace him, but at that time he was not available. The public, having seen her supporting a murder case accused, immediately they chased her and she tried to run away. In that running away, her sari was pulled over and she fell down. So this is in a sarcastic way they have written. Ultimately, she filed a case against the Malayala Manorama newspaper. The newspaper, same, Article 19, they said they have to face difficult situations if they do not speak out truth. The thing happened, in good faith they have written, or they have taken the most successful defense in good faith or in right perspective, they stated ultimately. What happened is, the running of the lawyer, So she, it was proved and she fell down. It was also proved there is nothing wrong because it is a fact. So since it is a fact, the High Court stated that it is the nullity. The lawyer cannot take it as an innuendo. Yes, it happened. Since it happened, even though she fell down, so in a sarcastic manner they have written, but it is not innuendo. And there is one other famous case, Fox versus Boulter. Of course, it's happened in Britain. So Fox was an MP and Boulter was a businessman. So regarding the webcasting, this Boulter is the owner of that Sky News also. He has commented adversely against the Fox, stating that since he supported a businessman, he did not come to the court and give evidence. So conveniently, the MPs abstain to attend the courts, he has written. So when you go into the deep of meaning, it is indicating that this MP has got support of the, he supports the business people, which is not at all correct. And this case was decided very recently in the year 2009 and stated that it comes under innuendo. So here, please understand, innuendo means an indirect or implied reference. So at the outset, by if you look into the just sentence, it is not a defamation. But if you go through the meaning, definitely it comes to innuendo. So this is one part of the defamation. So definitely you can go for legal, or you can claim a case both under civil and criminal also. So if you want to civil, you have to pay the court fees. If you want to go for criminal, you have to file a case under section 500 IPC, both for libel and slander. So please read this topic. Of course, it may be given as a, of course, short question for you. Anyway, since it has come to light in the Guntur Arundalpet case, of course, when I come to the class, I will tell you in detail because it's not a decided case. Guntur case is not a decided case, but you, these are the decided cases. Please study them carefully. Thank you.